Hey y'all, it's Renessa, and if you follow me for any period of time, then you know that I am all about equipping you to discover design and get highly paid to do work you love, whether that means radically changing careers, launching your business, or bringing your big idea to life. So I am crafting a really quick video because I just want to go deep with you on something. So a couple of days ago, I sent out a love note to the crew, to all of y'all, about big leaps. And why getting highly paid to do work you love is going to require you to step through a big, or it's going to require you to make a big leap. And that leap for some of you could be financial. It could be an emotional leap where you've got to work through some limiting beliefs on confidence and worth and value. It could be habits or changes that you need to make. It could be as simple as forgiveness, where you've got to really let some things go so that you're free to move forward and step into a space that you are really called to add value in. And so I was excited about the feedback that came from people in response to that email and some of the conversations that I've had in response to that email. And so I wanted to go deeper on one of the leaps because I think it would serve folks. And so one of those leaps is the money leap. And we're gonna talk about that because it's a big deal for some of you. It's a big deal for me. It's a big deal that I've had to grow through over the years. And so, you know, so many people get excited about creating their perfect work. They're like, oh my God, I'm so ready. I've wanted this for years. And, you know, I'm fired up. And they're fired up until they realize that their big leap is the money, or better yet, parting with the money, or getting resourceful on how to find the money to then be able to invest in themselves and grow in the way that they want to grow. And so money is not, you know, just to be clear, it's not a big deal for everybody. Like there's some folks who have just lots of disposable income. And so for them, if they see value in something, if it's something that they want, they don't think anything, they don't think twice about spending the money. There are others, however, and this conversation is for you, where money is an issue, where either money is tight or money, you're having to budget or whatever, but more specifically, you might be someone where you're comfortable now, you're good to go, but you may have come from a place where money was tight, or you may have had situations where, you know, you went through a rough patch, it was bankruptcy, or you had to foreclose on your home, or you had some experience where you have a real scarcity around money. And so even when you have it, you are so not going to part with it because you are afraid of, I am never going back there. I'm never going to put myself in that position. I'm not going to live like I grew up, or whatever the meaning happens to be. And so what's happening with your perfect work is that you are delaying your ability to get what you want because you're not willing to invest in yourself. You're not willing to pay for speed. And so for many of us, when we think about investing in ourselves, we think about going back to school. Oh, I'm going to get my graduate degree. I'm going to get my MBA. And I've had conversations with amazing women the last couple of weeks who've gone back for master's degrees, or they've come out of school. One woman was a valedictorian out of her college and came out of school and could not get a job. And so the craft and the knowledge that we build in education, which I'm a big proponent of, does not equate to monetizing your perfect work, whether that's monetizing it in elevating your salary or monetizing it in growing your business. And so it's critical that you're willing to pay for speed in order to be able to monetize your perfect work, because dream job and broke don't go together. It ain't perfect work if you is dream job and you ain't making no money, whether it's career, business, or otherwise, right? And so some of you listening in, you know, you're perfect. You want to write a book that transforms people. You want to start a business that's going to give you flexibility and freedom to kind of be location independent. You want to pivot to do work that you really enjoy without having to start all over salary-wise, or you might just want to elevate yourself in your career and become a leading authority and have more influence and have a bigger title and have more income or whatever, right? The goal is you've got to find someone or someone's or resources who are doing the thing that you want to do and can teach you how to do it, where you go and you pay for that speed so that you get there faster and you get there without making all of the DIY do-it-yourself mistakes. Let me share how this works, how this has worked in my life, because that's one of the things that I can say I'm really strong at. Like even when I didn't know what the hell I was doing, I was paying somebody to figure out what the hell I wasn't doing. because I believed in show me, I want what you have. When I wanted to get on television and start doing, you know, TV segments and news segments, what did I do? I sat down and I paid a woman from Ireland who had been on television in the States. And I was like, please show me how to do that. And that's how I launched my coaching business, by going on television and doing exactly what she told me to do in order to call TV stations and go book myself on TV, right? But I didn't just sit there and think, oh, how am I going to do it? And let me just figure it out and call and have people hang up on me. Tell me what to say. Tell me what to do. This is what I tried. It didn't work. What do I need to shift? That's what's paying for speed. And so let me give you this example. When I first started out coaching, and I guess you called it coaching, I didn't know what I was doing. I just knew I wanted to add some value. I didn't know who my perfect customer was. I didn't know any of that. I was just kind of out there just doing the best I could do, right? Which is sometimes where people start. Anyway, so I had a friend who was a trainer, and she had this contract that she had with this international school. And every year she would come in and she would do some training for their staff. Well, that particular year she'd gotten pregnant and she wasn't going to do the training. And so she reached out to me and she said, oh, I just wanted to see if you wanted to take over this contract. I've been doing it with them for years. I mean, they're a nonprofit. They're an international school. They don't have a lot of money. I've only charged them about $1,000 a year. They're not going to pay much more than that. I don't really, you know, I think that's probably, you know, maybe $1,200 you can get, but not much more than that. So in my mind, I'm like, well, that's not a lot of money for all that you're going to do, you know, in this training. Unbeknownst to her, I had invested in this coach to teach me how to speak. I wanted to learn how to speak. And I knew I wanted to learn how to get paid to speak. Let me be real clear. I knew that with speakers, there's some speakers who make a little bit of money and there's some speakers who make a lot of bit of money. And I wanted to make a lot of bit of money and I wanted to learn how to do it. And so this speaker was the big money speaker. And I was like, yeah, that's my guy. And so I paid, oh my gosh, it was probably like $10,000 or something crazy to enter in his program and start to learn how the business of speaking. I didn't need someone to teach me what to say and how to say and where to stand and all that. I didn't want the mechanics. I wanted the business. I wanted the money. I wanted to learn how to monetize it, right? And so I've been going through his program. I've been learning some things and applying what he'd said. And so when this opportunity came, I was like, I'm going to get paid more than $1,000 for this. That's, you know, even though I knew I would take $1,000, if that's all I could get, I would take it, but I was going to pitch higher, you know? And so I'd been learning from him how to package my value, how to find things that I had and could offer that wasn't a stretch for me. It was something I could do out of the back of my hand, but had a higher perceived value for the customer such that they would be willing to pay a premium for that thing. And so I sat with the customer, I understood their needs, I figured it out, and I went back and I did pull together a proposal based on what I was learning. And again, I didn't know what I was doing. I just knew that this is what I was learning, these are the strategies, and this is what I'm gonna apply, and I'm gonna go out there and do it. So I pulled together this proposal, ends up the client pays me $4,900 for the same training that my friend had been getting $1,000 for. And I was fired up. Why? Because in my mind, the threshold was $1,000. And so just with some ingenuity and some creativity and some strategies and some know-how, which I didn't have before, $4,900. And with one client, I had, you know, 49% repay what I had invested in myself. But the skill is something that I wash, rinse, and repeat. It's part of why I get highly paid now. And so the point is, you know, learning how to pay for speed will allow you to get where you want to go faster and get better results, as opposed to trying to get a free idea here, get a free idea there, get inspired and not knowing how to execute. And so from there, invested in somebody else to teach me how to package and create programs and coach in different kinds of ways. And I think that was maybe like $15,000. And I was like, oh my God, what am I going to do? And what if I fail? And what if I don't make it? And blah, blah, blah. But I was committed to me and I was committed to learning and I was committed to applying. That $15,000 investment turned into $145,000 year of revenue and sales because of the things that I've learned. But you can't take that knowledge away from me. I can wash, rinse, and repeat it. And so what does this mean for you? Some of you, you know, you want to get to a certain level in your career. You want to elevate and become a better leader. There are executive coaches out there. There are programs, there are forums, there are things that you can invest in and involve in and put yourself in an environment where you can do what you want to do. Some of you want to be on boards. There are people who help you get there. Some of you want to do a TED Talk. There's somebody out there actually who teaches people how to get on TED Talks. And so you can go out there, pitch and fail and reject on your own, or you can figure out how to take the leap and invest the money to do what you need to do to get what you want and to get it faster, quicker, easier, and with less stress, heartache, wasted time and money, right? This applies to parenting. This applies to losing weight. This applies to finding a spouse. I mean, there's countless examples of where paying for speed comes into play, but I guarantee you, if you are looking to do your perfect work, there is a place for you where you're going to need to take a big leap, and that leap is going to be money. And so instead of looking at it as I'm afraid to spend, think about it as I'm paying for speed and what kind of return can I get on this investment if I'm committed to me and I'm willing to take a bet on me. So I hope this serves you because I just got in the atmosphere that was a conversation that people were having in their heads. And I know it's hard and it's challenging and sometimes it can be scary, but we ain't got time to play and we don't have time to waste. There's a world that's out there that's waiting for you and they're looking for you and they want what you have to offer that you haven't even figured out how to put out. There's a company out there that's waiting. There are people who want to be led by you. There are books that need to be read that are authored by you. So get out there, pay for speed, and take your big leap. I'll talk to you next time. Bye-bye.